Monsieur le Président,
Mr. Chairman, first I'd like to congratulate you on your election as chairman of the 17th Conference of the States Parties. We are certain that under your experienced conduct, the deliberations of this Assembly will be crowned with success. Allow me to assure you of the complete cooperation of my delegation in the coming days. Mr. Chairman, this year marks the 15th anniversary of the Chemical Weapons Convention. Since entry into force, significant progress has been made by the OPCW and its member states. We trust that the years to come will also be marked by sustained commitment in favor of the prohibition of chemical weapons. Next year, the states parties to the convention will assemble in The Hague for the third review conference. We think that it is absolutely crucial to take this opportunity to identify the way forward and strengthen still further the convention. Switzerland welcomes the preparatory work by the open-ended working group under the guidance of the ambassador of Algeria with a view to preparing this conference. The process of review ought to be inclusive and attract wide support in order to attain the objectives. We're getting ready, we must get ready to for the transition which is facing the OPCW because its principal mission is to prevent the reappearance of the threat of chemical war and the use of chemical substances for hostile purposes. We think it's essential that the OPCW continue to concentrate on its primary vocation, which is as an organization for chemical disarmament and non-proliferation and as a center of excellence for all matters related to chemical weapons. Switzerland regrets that, despite the extension of the deadlines for destroying the declared stockpiles, not all the states parties have been able to complete their commitments. It enjoins them to pursue their efforts with a view to destroying the remaining weapons as soon as possible. Switzerland welcomes the reform process launched by the Director General, to whom the report of the consultative group offers a valuable, valuable food for thought. We are ready to contribute actively to the discussion and are certain that we'll come to a successful conclusion in finding the way forward. In order to continue its indispensable role, the OPCW ought to have available the resources and means appropriate to its task. Switzerland therefore welcomes the revised draft program and budget from the Director General for 2013. However, and also it approves the draft decision adopted on the budget by the EC at its 70th session. Mr. Chairman, the pertinence and credibility of this of the CWC as an instrument of disarmament and non-proliferation depends on its ability to adapt to rapid progress in science and technology. In this context, Switzerland has welcomed the or has hosted the IUPAC seminar on developments in science and technology in which are connected to the convention in Spies in February this year. This progress, while possibly bringing new opportunities, could at the same time be a challenge for the application of the convention. Switzerland welcomes the recent report of the SAB for the third review conference. Like the Scientific Advisory Board, we feel that the technical discussions on incapacitating agents have been exhaustive. We approve also the recommendation made to the Technical Secretariat, namely to start technical preparations for verifying the activities which might be necessary during an investigation of the use of this kind of chemical. Switzerland has presented a draft proposal for the third review conference with a view to opening an exhaustive targeted debate on the use of incapacitating agents for repressive purposes. This debate ought to allow us to install to inspire transparency and confidence among the states parties. We're certain that the review conference will be an excellent opportunity to discuss the SEB recommendations. I should also like to stress the fact that our initiative is not to modify the convention in any way. I invite all interested delegations to take part in a forthcoming event in this connection. Mr. Chairperson, it is crucial to maintain and reinforce the almost universal prohibition on chemical weapons. Promoting adhesion of all states to the convention must be one of OPCW's priorities. Switzerland welcomes the progress accomplished these last years and is ready to sustain the efforts that are already underway to persuade those states which haven't done so to adhere to the convention. We call on all states to do so as early as possible. The existence recently confirmed of stockpiles of chemical weapons in Syria reinforces this desire for universality. My country deplores the situation in Syria and appeals to the Syrian authorities to renounce definitively the use of chemical weapons and to destroy them as soon as possible. At the same time, it is fundamental that the convention be applied fully at national level by all states' parties. We are concerned to note that at the 17th session of the Executive Council, 99 states' parties had not yet implemented the necessary legislative measures under Article 7. We think that the convention will not be effective without adequate legislative and executive measures. Switzerland so thus encourages all states parties to meet their obligations provided for under the convention. And given the complexity of the requirements of Article 7, the proposition of dividing the report into core requirements and additional requirements could allow us to see progress made in this direction. As regards international cooperation and assistance, Switzerland continues to attach great importance to the implementation of Article 10. To that end, we've organized training courses in the competence center of the Swiss Army in Spies, and we will continue to do so. Switzerland also approves fully the propositions aiming to reinforce regional cooperation. I renew the expression of our support for the Technical Secretariat here. Mr. Chairman, I would like to welcome the recent conclusion by the Director General of an agreement, an additional agreement with the Director, with the Secretary General of the United Nations, because he will have influence in cases where a non-state party has chemical weapons or they are present on a territory not under the control of a non-state party.
Session de la conférence des États parties. Monsieur le Président, je vous remercie de votre attention.